I used to go about with Audrey Monks. She didn't look like an horse.
More of a pony, but then you were only 11.
Audrey Monks, Audrey Monks.
Blonde hair, blue eyes.
And about 8 stitches on her chin.
I remember, a bit of a tomboy.
She was brilliant with a catapult.
Didn't she once bite the CD mistress?
She had lovely teeth.
11.
She had more than 11.
11 years of age, I was about to say when I was so rudely interrupted.
No, I should think. She only lost about 8.
Seems just incredible that we were ever 11 years of age.
And she lost 4 of them when she fell off that thing at the safety exhibition.
When she used to smile after that, bless her, it was like looking through a turnstile.
Makes me sad sometimes when I think back.
You know, when I was 11 years of age, I wanted to be a fighter pilot. Of course, they were all double winkers then.
Now they're all one. There's progress for you. It's just another word for saving material.
Hey, what did you want to be at 11?
Heavy smoker.
Good morning, young lady. I would like to see your personnel manager.
Have you got an appointment?
No, not exactly.
Well, you can't then.
So much for looking them straight in the eye.
Excuse me, miss, but why don't you stop practicing all that charm and just nip through and ask him if he'll see this gentleman for just 2 minutes?
Hey, you don't know what you're missing. He actually likes work.
No, it doesn't matter. It's the same response everywhere. Brings a twitch to your war wounds.
It does matter.
Oh, if it's a vacancy you're after, you'll have to fill in the standard application forms.
2 minutes, that's all.
And leave them with us, together with the telephone numbers of 2 referees, after which you will be contacted, if necessary.
2 minutes, during which he can, if he likes, continue venerating a photograph of the managing director.
He's got his pension, he won't want but wages. His crackers, he'd make an ideal worker.
I do not know these people, young lady. I was merely foolish enough to drop something in their gaps on the street.
Well, I suggest you all clear off and try the neighbour exchange.
If you don't mind my saying so, miss, I think you're a bit wasted here. You ought to be out tending the dying with a whip. As a final inducement for you to go through, let me introduce my friend here. He used to be the Huddersfield Strangler, but now he's out on probation.
Can you get it?
You set me off to a rotten first impression. What's she got to tell him now?
She's going to say there's a bloke out there with the Huddersfield Strangler looking for a job.
I have never felt so humiliated in my life.
Oh, come on. Yes, you have. What about that time when we left you holding Mrs. Jack Horbury?
Don't remind me. She shouldn't have been up there in the first place. A woman of her impressive physique. It's all very well stopping them falling, but I never know where to put my hands.
In your pocket. Pay for the tees.
The centre of gravity was all wrong.
Ah, but you were cuddly though, weren't it?
And I seem to remember a time when you were exposed without your trousers in the men's department of J.W. Mulcaster and Sons.
Only because he did something unmentionable in the fitting room.
Well, he'd been in there half an hour. How long does it take to buy a pair of trousers?
How long does it take? How long?
Take me a long time before I bought a pair like that.
I'll admit they're going a bit here and there.
Here and there? If I look through here, I can see everything that's there.
I wouldn't be surprised if that isn't the exact same movement whereby Salome used to inflame King Herod.
He'd be inflamed, all right, if he clapped eyes on that trotting round the palace.
It's bingo now.
What is bingo now?
The palace. They closed it right down after the Vicar and the Virgin.
Not that palace.
It was double X the last week I was here.
You were there all week.
No, you daft fella. Just the last performance. The other film was Swedish.
Well, it would be, wouldn't it?
I can't remember what it was called. But it were about this lumberjack who had a big chopper. And he were going to chop this bird's tree down, so she tied herself to it without on. So he went and had a go at this big horse chestnut.
Well, like a boy, wouldn't you?
Oh, it happens all the time in the forestry commission.
She said something to him in Swedish. He nearly missed his stroke, nearly took off his foot. Oh, I don't know what it was she said. It had subtitles.
It had what?
Subtitles. And they were right down the bottom of the screen. I'd paid my money to come in and watch them. Not when there was this daft bird jack naked tied there to this county great tree.
Subtitles.
And they were right down at the bottom of the screen.
Ambitious, a real goer, want to earn 4,000 a year, no experience necessary, apply 14 Gordon Street to Mr. Green.
Well, it doesn't look as though they got 4,000 quid.
All right, don't knock it, just because it's not got a lot of flash executive top show.
Well, that's true, they don't go in for a lot of flash executive top show.
Premises,
but I've got the architects in at my prestige office block, and I find it best to keep out of the way with all those architects around the place because they're like a load of delicate marines whispering about the place.
Old Barry's youngest went for a draftsman.
Oh, yes.
I can draw you a plan of a garage if you ever want one.
I remember that.
Or a conservatory. Don't have to be a garage.
Oh, versatile, is he? Well, so are we. A shiny door. There's no such thing as sales resistance. Only bad salesmanship. That's our motto. The shiny glow motto.
Or a shed. You know, I think you could draw a shed. Will you keep quiet? Wish you wouldn't keep rambling on about your Barry's youngest. We know he made the grade education, Lee, but look at the advantages he had. All those small private classes at Bolton.
Sorry about that, Mr. Green. Oh, that's all right. It's never been part of the Oswald Green method to stifle free discussion. Unless, of course, they're customers. In which case, prudence dictates that they ought never get a word in edgeways. Now, remember that. Your first free gem of sales wisdom from the lips of Oswald Green. Don't write it down. Keep it in here. You stick with me, boys, and I'll send you out on the streets as sharp as razors. You'll be able to slice your way through all resistance. You'll have shiny glow. Get up and go. What will you have? Come on, tell me.
Shine and get up. And kaboom.
That's it. That's what you'll have. This is your promise from Oswald P. Green. Well, this is it, boys. A product. You hardly go. Feel it. How does that grab you? Right weight, right place. A revolutionary new air assault cleaner, guaranteed to put the sparkle back in anything, even your mother's smile. Use that if you like, lads. Another free gem from Oswald Green.
It's rusty.
I told you it was revolutionary. Now let me tell you what makes a thing sell. Image. Clear product identity. You stick that little beauty on the shelf, and you forget the competition. The housewife can spot shiny glow anywhere. And she knows that we are shiny glow. Haven't wasted her money tarting up the package. But we've put value where it counts. Inside the can.
Remember, all the value is in the gun.
the steed there and all. I've got the knack of it. You just have to wobble up one gentleman. There you are, you see? We'll have to think positively. This stuff polishes anything.
Ha ha ha! Time, all right, we'll waste time. I found you a quiet spot. Enjoy it.
Cyril, could I ask you something?
What is it now?
Could you tell me why we're lying on this ancestor?
Over on UK TV Gold tonight, Victoria Wood can't bear to see what's cooking out in the fire escape. That's in Dinner Ladies at 9 o'clock.